The town of Forges in the French province of Brittany has a lovely old town surrounding one of Europe's largest castles, and we catch it on a beautiful morning just as the sun is rising over the sleepy village. Hi, I'm Jim Haswell. Join us as we stroll around the lovely old town of Forges.
Today is one of our longest driving days, heading down to the Loire Valley. So we break it up with a quick stop in the beautiful old town of Forges, hoping to find a nice cafe for our morning coffee and breakfast, and take a short stroll around the old castle in the center of town. The skies are clear, and the morning sun illuminates the castle walls beautifully. Its castle has 13 towers, and its walls are wonderfully preserved. It's about 8 a.m., and we were pleasantly surprised at how quiet it is in its touristy old town. On our trip, we found a common in the smaller old town centers for the cafes not to be open till around 11 a.m., and Forges was our first experience of this. So although we were disappointed not to find an open cafe for our much-needed first coffee of the day, we very much enjoyed wandering the peaceful streets on such a fine morning. Construction of the castle started in 1176 by the Baron of Forges, 10 years after King Henry II of England burnt down the first wooden fort. It has four working water wheels that power a small mill. In the medieval period, Forges was a strategic location on the eastern edge of Brittany at a crossroads of trade routes. To the northeast was Normandy, controlled by the King of England, and to the east was the Kingdom of France. So it was a focal point of power struggles, and it was continually upgraded. Over its first 200 years, it changed hands a few times between the Duke of Brittany and the King of France. And in 1449, it was taken by the English during the Hundred Years' War, but then reclaimed by the French 40 years later. During the French Revolution, it was used as a prison and changed hands a few more times between the Royalists and Republicans. And then in the 19th century, it hosted a shoe factory and was finally declared a monument in 1862.
If you enjoy my video style and content, I encourage you to subscribe by clicking on my channel icon. Expressing your likes and comments in YouTube and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.